much. Woo! Nice. Thank you. That's very nice. That's just the way we rehearsed it. Thank you for coming tonight. We got a good show. I don't mean to influence you before I start, but I found something today you should know. It was in the paper. Scientists just discovered that laughter eliminates cellulite. This is gonna be more fun tonight, because last night we had an audience that was not, they were just no fun. During the monologue, they decided it was more fun in the heat, and they went back outside and got in line. Remember the lady who was here?
Yeah.
Released the jar of moths. So they flew up and blocked out the letters in the applause sign. She was not a nice one. Very spiffy.
You like this? Got it from Pinky Lee.
Pinky's still around, too.
Yeah, I see him occasionally.
Anyway, I know a lot of you, some of you probably went on the NBC tour today. Maybe you didn't. Did they take you to the NBC commissary? Good, good. Don't go in there. No, you should not go in the kitchen at the NBC commissary. Have you ever seen what's going on in that place? They got a roach motel in there. And I saw one of the roaches having himself paged at the pool. Give you an idea. A chef, the chef over there, I don't know where they got him. We call him the Lord of the Flies. You know Alonzo, don't you?
Yes, sure.
Always wears rubber gloves.
Yeah.
You know why? What? So he won't catch anything. I know you're all tourists because most of the people who live in Los Angeles are busy preparing for the Olympics. They're partitioning their doghouse into hotel rooms. No, it's hard to believe they start a year from from today. A year from today's July 28th.
Right.
A year from today. And on that day, a runner carrying a torch, and he will be the last runner of hundreds of runners, I guess, who carry the flame in a relay all the way from Greece. And that last runner will just reach the freeway outside the stadium and be wiped out. Sad. You had an offer to rent your house out?
Not yet.
Lots of people in Los Angeles who live here.
Yeah.
Have a chance to lease out their house. And a lot of foreign countries are leasing homes just for the Olympics. But if you live in Los Angeles and you get a letter from the Ayatollah, be careful if the lease says day one. It's a bad lease. I was watching some television this morning. I normally don't watch daytime television. Everybody's got an exercise tape out. Jane Fonda's, what is it called, a workout thing? Mm-hmm. Richard Simmons, and I didn't know you. I saw yours this morning.
Yeah.
Wow. Ed's got a two-hour tape of Ed getting bombed in his underwear. It's called Ed's... called Ed's Barfer Size. Good news for sports fans, especially George Brett. The president of the American League ruled that George Brett's pine tar home run will stand.
Yeah.
Billy Martin accepted it calmly by opening the window of his car and mooning George Brett's mother. When the Dodgers heard that, they went out and bought the rights to the La Brea Tar Pits. What else is happening? Henry Kissinger's been in the news, as you know why, of course. He has been appointed to head a special commission on the problems in Latin America, and he's done a heck of a job so far. Today he reigns that Bob Hope's Christmas monologue to the troops will be broadcast in a Spanish simulcast. I knew that was going to go right into the...
And you were right.
I said to myself when I saw that one, that's not going to get much. And it didn't even live up to that expectation. Reagan was in the news today. He appointed, I guess every president does this, but he appointed a commission to look into organized crime and the mob's control of segments of Americans' life. The president is using those powers under the Big Al Doctrine, similar to the Monroe Doctrine.
That's true.
Did I peak too soon? Okay, here's something I think you'll enjoy. You, of course, are the final judges of all of this. Doc was in the paper today. Doctor has written a book, and he claims that vitamin C, among other things, increases sexual desire.
Yeah.
Now, one of the orange juice companies has already cashed in on this by changing their slogan. It says, give her a Minute Maid, and you'll be made in a minute. I think there's some truth to that, that vitamin C increases sexual prowess. I have a bottle of vitamin C in my medicine cabinet. It attacked my kaopectate. Some wonderful news from the telephone company. Did you see this? Telephone bills are going up again this next year. And they're going to charge $2 a month for long-distance service, whether you use it or not. You think the phone companies get away with the murderous activities? Yeah, that's not fair. The only alternative, I guess, is pigeons, and we're busy eating them. So. Actually, Congress does have a plan to help out the poor people who cannot afford the increased phone rates. They're going to give them a match, a hibachi, and a blanket. So they can send us. You guys should do a simulcast hand transmission for this month. Be a shame, though, if the, what are you starting
You're
to laugh
going
at?
Going back there again?
What? What am I going back where?
To that area of jokedom?
I was only going to say, be a shame if most people lost their phone service and wouldn't be able to talk to bill collectors or poll takers or people who call at 2 a.m. and saying, is Rudy there? Be a shame, you know? My special guest tonight. My special guest just returned from a visit with Russia's Yuri Andropov. Of course, I'm talking about Joan Collins. According to the tabloid, she's dating him. Joan Collins, yeah, she's an attractive lady. She stars in Dynasty, as you know, one of my favorite shows. It's about a story about a powerful man living in a spacious mansion. I watch the show for nostalgia. Actually, I'm talking about the delightful 11-year-old girl, Samantha Smith, who was with us about 6 weeks ago, who was returned from a 2 weeks trip in Russia, and she's going to be out here, and one little thing happened on her vacation. She lost her traveler's checks in Russia, but luckily they had an American Express office in Minsk, one of the big cities there. Okay, I think I've tapered down now. Along with Miss Collins, we have a lovely singer. Shelley West is with us.
Yep.
Joan Collins and Samantha Smith. And we shall be...
See those drumsticks, drummer. Too much.
Shelley West. Should mention, tomorrow night on the show, we're doing something a little bit different. Mm-hmm. As you probably know, that there was a lot of controversy about the presidential debate of 1980 with then-President Carter and Ronald Reagan. And there were a lot of allegations that someone in the Carter camp gave the Reagan aides Carter's briefing book before the debate so Reagan could be better prepared and anticipate Carter's strategy. So tomorrow on the show, we got a hold of the tape from the network of the actual debate. And we're going to look at it again tomorrow night, and you may be able to pick up...
With a second look, you
might... A second look, yeah. To see if that possibly could be true, if the president was had any ammunition sold. Yeah. That's tomorrow on the show. We were amazed when we saw the tape.
It was just amazed. So many points.
Wasn't noticed. Obvious at all on the original debate, no.
But now you know.
Yeah.
That's tomorrow night.
Yeah, yep. Tomorrow night. Do you use hairspray at all?
Yes.
Would you have used hairspray 10, 15 years ago?
No.
Why not?
Because 10 or 15 years ago, my hair was kind of just all by itself, kind of flattened down, didn't need anything.
No, but another reason.
No, I tell you, you know what it is now? You wash your hair every day, and right. You dry it.
Men generally would not have used a hairspray 10 or 15 years ago because that's effeminate.
Right.
Guys very, very often wouldn't wear cologne.
No.
Now you wear, shirts, striped shirts.
Well, I was wearing shirts 15 years ago. I got into it early.
Would you have worn a pink shirt or something like that?
Kind of, yeah, because being in show business, it's different. Show business is
our
life.
Anyway, you're not helping my setup.
What do you want?
Say you know you wouldn't have.
No, I would not.
Well, of course he wouldn't have. And the reason for that is...
You're damn right.
Yeah. Those things become acceptable because of advertising.
Right.
Perfume, soaps, lots of things that people probably could exist with and live and not lose all their friends if you didn't use a deodorant.
You wonder how the pioneers crossed the nation.
That's why they had those wagons in a circle. You ever think that? Because the breeze would... Advertising does it. Let's be honest. They create a need for a product that maybe there wasn't there before.
Luckily, they have the product.
That's right. Now, we've done some research. Sometimes you're a help, and sometimes... I think I have this all locked in, and you take me off on another tangent.
What is it you're trying to tell us?
Well, I'm trying to tell us with that in mind. See, one of the rules of this show is when we get ready to do a piece of humorous material, we like to set it up so the audience knows that this is not Alastair Cook saying, welcome to Masterpiece Theater. So, actually, what we've done, we've made a survey of some products that soon will be available in the stores. This is a first-time look that you may not need all of these products. You got it? Okay. Now, for people who are into exercise and jogging, right?
Right.
Okay, they sell all kinds of specialized products, such as liniment, muscle rub, shoes. This is for soccer players who suffer from athlete's head. And it's called Dr. Scholl's hat.
You're right, a setup really helps a bit.
I just like the word hat. I put that one in there. Okay, they sell stuff that are thinly disguised hangover remedies, right?
Mm-hmm.
Stuff that fizzes. You know about that. Stuff that fizzes. Liquid that coats your stomach for hangovers and so forth. This is for a person who had a lot to drink the night before, and you can see it right here. So this will be on the market soon. This is called the Tongue Power More.
That'll go.
You see, that could do. You put that in there and do that. Now, here's something you really don't need to help you find your mouth in the dark. It's called the nose nostril light. Probably 50 big ones for that. We'll move along here rapidly and get to the rest of the show. For gourmet dog lovers, new product coming out you probably don't need. This is called the Pooper Cuisinart. Usually props are surefire. You got props. Let's see. We got that one. Okay. You've heard of extra strength Tylenol, extra strength Bufferin, and so forth. Here's one for people with really heavy wax buildup in your ears. The Q-tip grenade. Okay, they're always trying to sell you products, as you know, that are bathroom products that are different colors, sanitized, squeezable. They've gone too far with this next item. Scenic Check toilet paper. For jealous senior citizen husbands, the Chastity earphone. Chastity ear horn. horn with a lock on it. Big bad lock with a horn. Okay. This is for the man who doesn't. A lot of people use an underarm spray. You know, that's a pretty acceptable behavior. Here's a man who doesn't want any chance at all of offending. He came out with this. The Odor Eater Business Suit. Here's one for the bachelor with a very active romantic life. Answering machine shorts. When he's out of town, these will pick up his messages. And at an advantage, it feels pretty good when he pressed fast forward. Okay. Heavy drinkers who can't make it through the morning without a drink, a margarita on a rope. Not going to be seeing these in a store or here again. For men concerned about their appearance, they've got hair coloring, you know, hair transplants. This is one for mooners who want to look good for the ladies. The bun toupee. Okay, and a few years ago they started selling, you know, air fresheners, room air fresheners. Now they've escalated with this product for people with really tough household orders. The room roll-on deodorant. Cornucopia with a padlock. I'm going to keep working on this one. I'm going to get something out of this before the show ends. Barbara Streisand's nose with a padlock. Okay. I know. Forgive me for that. That was a cheap shot. I'll come up with something better before the show's over. I cut that one.
All right. Shame to waste a nice prop.
I'll show you why I cut it.
All right.
You've heard of traps for household pets, like the Roach Motel?
Yes.
This is the Roach Washington Monument. You folks are always right. Always right. All right, Joan Collins is going to join us. Samantha Smith will be with us in just a moment, the young lady. We spent a couple of weeks in Russia, and Shelley West will be here to sing for us. So stay where you are, and we'll be back. Thank
you. Want to try another one?
A hickey out of control. We still got some time left. A couple of weeks ago, we had this delightful young lady with us. She's been in newspapers and all over the world, and she wrote to and received a reply from the Soviet premier, president, Yuri Andropov. And she toured the Soviet Union. I can't wait to find out how she enjoyed the trip. Would you welcome Samantha Smith? Yeah, I know you were excited the last time we talked about going to the Soviet Union, right?
Yes.
And what kind of reaction did you get to your last appearance on this show? Did you get a chance to see it later in the evening?
Not later in the evening.
Huh?
I fell asleep, but
I know the feeling. Somebody told me where you lived or something. They didn't carry it, or.
Yeah.
Your friends didn't get to see it for some reason?
I got bumped by the Boston Red Sox game.
They had a Boston Red Sox game, and they didn't get to see that episode.
Right.
Well, that's too bad. But you got the tape later.
Right.
Right? Yeah. Well, tell me about the trip now. How do you prepare? The problem I have when I go on a trip, and they say it's tougher for women, is what to pack. You know, men throw some couple of sport coats and slacks and a couple of shirts, and we go. Now, how did you prepare?
Well, since we were gonna be meeting lots of kids.
Right.
And other people. So we packed about 2 suitcases of presents and gifts, hats, pencils, T-shirts, right. So on. And then the rest of it, we just packed clothes.
Just clothes, huh?
Yeah.
Did they like the gifts? What did most of the Russian youngsters like to get? T-shirts? You give them T-shirts with, you know...
I don't know what they like best, but...
Yeah?
The kids, we'd give out, like, hats and T-shirts, and the grown-ups, pencils, pins.
Right. You landed in Moscow. That was your first stop. Mm-hmm. What was your first impression when you arrived at the city of Moscow? You probably read about it and you've seen pictures, but...
Well, when I first got to Moscow, the airport, it looks American. I wasn't sure if we were in Moscow or not.
And they have our planes already? You mean it's like American airports?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah? You expect to see different looking airplanes or what?
Well, not really. They're pretty much the same, except the names of them are printed in Russian.
Right. Who met you at the airport?
Natasha and Gennady. I didn't catch their name, the last names.
Yeah. Well, it's nice when you're in a foreign country to be on a first name basis anyway. But Natasha?
Natasha.
Natasha.
And Gennady.
And Gennady? Well, both grown-ups.
Mm-hmm.
Now, were they representing the Soviet government or officials of the...
Well, they worked for the Friendship House.
Right.
And Natasha...
All that means is we have to cut away to do a commercial.
Oh.
Yeah, well, can we come back and finish? I want to find out all about this trip, okay? Okay, we'll take a break and we'll be right back. It's like getting caught laughing in church, isn't it? All of a sudden, it's on, you go, Yeah, we were talking. She said you was nervous. You're not really nervous. You're very calm tonight. Does anybody ever call you Sam instead of Samantha?
Most people do.
You like that? Yeah. Or you prefer Samantha? Sam, okay?
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't make any difference. You were talking about these two friends you made, Nastasia and...
Natasha.
I don't speak Russian. Natasha and...
Gennady.
And you said they worked for the...
Friendship House.
Yeah. Did any of the people who met you at the airport speak any English at all?
Natasha is also my interpreter.
Ah.
So I got to be pretty close to her.
That's nice. Did you pick up any Russian at all? A few phrases?
Just a little bit.
Well, what'd you learn?
Спасибо, очень хорошо, хорошо.
Yeah? I don't know what any of those words mean.
Bolshoi
ballet. You know what Bolshoi means, really?
Great.
Yeah, great, or big. That's all it means.
You said you didn't know any Russian.
No, I did. I knew what it meant. Caught in a lie again. No, I just happen to know that most people think that had some significance. It just means big or great ballet, the Bolshoi ballet. All I know is yet, really, which is no.
Yes.
It's a difficult language to learn, isn't it?
No, not really.
No, it isn't. You're going to be a killer when you grow up. You are. Okay, what do you think of the Russian food? Now, you've been asked, I'm sure, most questions since you've been back by lots of people, but I'm interested in your interpretation.
Well, some of it I wasn't crazy about, but my favorite is Chicken Kiev.
Chicken Kiev?
Have you ever heard of that?
Yeah. That's right outside of Moscow. It's a small town. Chicken Kiev, yeah. That's just good. That's very tasty. Mm-hmm. Did you get anything, did you ever get in the mood for a good hamburger or something where over there?
Oh, yeah. When we went to see the American ambassador that was in Russia,
right.
We got to have hamburgers and French fries and all sorts of American food.
And you were ready for it about that time, weren't you? Now, they tell me the subways. Did you get a chance to see any of the subways at all?
Absolutely.
Tell me about
beautiful.
Those. Tell me about them. They say they're gorgeous.
They are, really. On the ceilings, they're painted like little tiles, you know, the rocks.
Right, like little murals or something?
Yeah. Huh? And pictures painted of war or something, showing the miseries or something like that.
Right.
And then other ones, other subway terminals are painted white and gold. And it looks just like a really expensive church or something.
That's what I hear. They say they're beautiful. Do they actually have chandeliers hanging in the subways?
Yes, they do.
Chandeliers?
Chandeliers.
Wonder how long those would last in New York. We have paintings in New York subways also. Number 5 aerosol can, I think, does it. Okay. Yeah. Now, you took some presents, T-shirts and stuff and so forth. You got a lot of things, too, didn't you?
Yes.
What did you get?
Well, a lot of it, I'm jealous of some of the kids because they sew so well. I got lots of stuffed animals that were sewn by them by hand.
Right.
And they look like they were just bought in a store. They're
beautiful,
really
made.
Good.
Yeah. So you got some stuffed animals.
Mm-hmm. And then I got books about Russia.
Right.
And mostly books and stuffed animals.
Yeah.
And, oh, I did get a Russian beauty costume.
Russian beauty costume?
Mm-hmm. Somebody might have seen it on TV. It's got, like, a sort of like a crown.
Mm-hmm.
And then a dress.
Yes. They're very, very lovely costumes. Mm-hmm. Are they got any girls as pretty in Russia as you are?
I think most of them are prettier.
Really? Oh, they must be knockouts then. Somebody told me you went to, was it a summer camp or a version of a summer
yes.
camp for a few days with a...
Arctic.
Mm-hmm.
And I was really surprised. Usually I'm really shy to meet new kids. But I was so surprised as soon as I touched the ground from getting down the stairs off the plane, they grabbed me and pulled me onto the bus.
Yeah? So kids are pretty much the same everywhere, you think, huh?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, you didn't get to meet Yuri Andropov, did you?
No.
What did they tell you was going on? Why didn't you get a chance to meet him?
They just said that he was too busy.
Just...
too busy.
Yeah, I guess world leaders get pretty busy sometimes. What kind of a send-off did you have when you came home?
Well, when we were our last, second-to-last day in Moscow,
mm-hmm.
second-to-last day there, some really important deputies came to our hotel to talk to us and brought over some presents, which is a giant samovar, a book, and a hand-painted box. I opened the box, and it was freshly painted because you could smell the paint.
Oh, you did pretty well. You think you'd like to live in Russia at all?
Well, it's nice to visit there. I'd rather live in my hometown.
Yeah, I think you're probably right. Of course, you're over there, you know, they probably show you, they kind of showcase everything and show you all the very nice things about Russia. Mm-hmm. And there's probably some things that maybe you're not aware of at your young age that a lot of people are not too happy about in that country. But I don't suppose you saw too much of that side, did you? Did any of the children over there, when they talk with you, have anything to say, ask you to say when you got back here, or no particular message or anything?
No.
Yeah. Are you planning, do you think you're going to keep in contact through letters with any of your friends you met?
Well, we're nowhere close to being definite about this, but I made a really close friend, Natasha, not the Natasha I was talking about before, but little Natasha I met.
Little Natasha.
I met her in Artec. She's 13, but my size.
Right.
She speaks very good English, I think. She says she doesn't have very good English, but I think it's good. We're thinking about we might invite her to America sometime.
Hey, that would be nice, wouldn't it? I think that exchange idea of young people going from, like, the student exchange program they have in many lands is a very good idea.
Yeah.
You have to start making contact with other peoples somewhere, even if you disagree with them, and that's not a bad way to do it through the young people, is it? Well, you're a charming young lady. The press has been following you all over the place. Are you getting tired of that at all?
Sort of, yeah.
Sort of? Answering a lot of the same questions and kind of being in the public eye?
Actually, some of the cameramen and some of the people I've gotten to be good friends with, like Scotty is one of the cameramen for Channel 6, mm-hmm. and I've gotten to be friends with Barbara Quill, too.
Oh, good for you. Well, you're a delightful young lady. I thank you for coming back and telling us about your trip, and I hope we'll see you again sometime.
I hope so, too.
Okay, thank you, Sam. I was fine. She's a nice young lady. Joan Collins will be out here in a moment. Okay, we have returned. Viewers all over, I guess probably all over the world, especially in this country, know my next guest as Alexis on the series Dynasty. She is certainly glamorous, sexy. Also has three teenagers. Would you believe that?
Wow.
Good comment.
You like that, huh?
Wow. Would you welcome Joan Collins? Yes, you're
wow
right.
Wow, is the right word.
Well, thank you very much. I have two teenagers.
Did I give you another child?
No, I have three children. One is the same age as Samantha, who I just saw outside.
Really? Isn't she nice?
She's divine. She
yeah.
Is. You're looking very attractive, I must say. Really? I was watching the show last night, and I switched off my set at 12:30, and I thought, my goodness me, think of all the women, the millions of women in America, when they go to sleep at night, you are the last face that they see. Isn't that exciting? Think of all the things that conjures up, Johnny.
I've never really given that a lot of thought, but yeah, it's kind of intriguing, isn't it?
Yes, I thought about that because Julio Iglesias, who's I don't know if you had on the show,
yes,
was telling
times.
Me the other day, he was talking about all the people, all the women were very attracted to him, and he said, don't you ever think about this, Joan, when you are on television, all the men that are looking at you, and I said, no, I never think about it. He said, think about it. It's very interesting what they're thinking about.
Does it help you through a long night to think about that? I'm going to
really?
Think about that this evening.
Really.
Yeah. Would you like to be 11 again? You just thought you'd be that age?
Not
today
really.
And have to go through all the changes that are taking place?
Oh, I think it's really tough to be a child today.
Yeah.
It really is, because they're so bright and they're so exposed to so many things that we were not exposed to when we were kids. I mean, I was a very protected child.
They're a lot more mature today.
Oh,
I know a lot.
Incredibly so. She's really mature, that little girl.
Yeah.
She really is.
Speaking of traveling, as she was, somebody said you were in France recently.
Yes.
Where you're not known particularly, because, I mean, you can walk around fairly...
Yes, I can.
Safely
I can,
there.
I can go into the supermarket, and I can go and pinch the peaches and touch the shaman and all of that, and nobody will say, hey, can I have your autograph? So it's nice, but the Dynasty is coming there in September.
There goes your privacy.
But I got robbed while I was there, which was not so nice.
You got robbed?
Yes. Thieves broke into my villa and robbed me of a lot of jewels, most of which was fake. Alexis's jewels.
You mean that stuff from the show that was what they call paste?
Yes. Of course, you don't think we wear the real thing, do you? We'd have to have armed guards everywhere.
I never thought of that. You could shoot Did you call Inspector Clouseau? to your room and solve the crime?
No, we had... Inspector Legrand.
No.
Who was not terribly prepossessing when I first met him, because he'd never heard of who I was, and they
right.
kept us waiting for a long time. And then when he found out that I was, the actrice famous, très famous, he came around a lot then to the villa, checking out the, my brother would say, Inspector Clouseau's here again.
Same thing.
Saying, I have to examine the grass to see if the thieves left any footprints. Of course, it hadn't rained for about 2 months.
Did they just say, kind of forget it, you will probably never see it again?
No. They gave me hope.
They're on the case.
Yeah, at least they didn't take my passport.
Yeah.
No, which was one good thing.
Most of the time when I see you, and especially when people see you on the show, you're always wearing knockout type stuff.
Thank you.
Especially on the show. What do you do when you just like to bum around?
Wear an old bathrobe or a pair of shorts or an old dress. I wear the same dress all the time, something that you can pull on and take off easily.
Yes.
To get your hair done.
Ah, yes. Now, I didn't believe this when somebody told me, because I did this when I was young also. You had an autograph collection.
Oh, yes!
I've never said that on the show before. You know,
did?
I collected autographs also.
Who did you have? Who were your favorites?
I came to California before I went in the service. I was about 17 years old, and I had Marlene Dietrich. I had them on playing cards.
On playing cards?
I was doing magic at the time, and I thought that would be a novel way to get autographs.
Oh, yeah.
And I used to go to the Hollywood Canteen out here.
Uh-huh.
And And they would sign these cards, and I had Orson Welles, and maybe 20 or 30 of them.
Oh, that's, you know, that's a great collection to
and
have.
Somebody stole them.
Oh.
Yes. Yeah.
No. Oh. I still have mine. I have Richard Widmark, Montgomery Clift.
You mean you actually David wrote Graham. Them as a teenager and
oh,
said, send me your
hobby.
Autograph?
Yes, that's why I always try and answer all my fan mail, if I possibly can. I mean, I can't answer, but I send pictures because I remember I had one particular favorite. It was an actor called John Payne. Remember John Payne?
Oh, John Payne, of course.
I wrote to him 4 times, and he never sent me an autographed picture. And I remember thinking that was really mean of him because each letter became more and more effusive. I think you're the most wonderful, the most handsome, the most glorious actor in the world. And he never sent me one. So now, I didn't like John Payne after that. So now, whenever I get anything, I always, answer.
Well, John Payne, if you're watching,
yes,
answer this lady's letters.
Yes.
Wouldn't it be funny if he's watching tonight and you get a picture and an autograph?
Yes.
After funny. All these years.
Yeah, but it was great because I used to also cut out pictures from magazines and put them in scrapbooks, and I have this massive scrapbook.
But you kept them.
Oh, I've got them, yes. I keep everything. I have a trunk full of old letters and autographed pictures and scrapbooks. I'm a squirrel. I keep everything. I mean, I'm a gypsy, but a squirrel.
But you don't want to throw things away.
I can't. It's part of my character.
Yeah, me too.
Is that, are you cancer?
No. Does that mean something?
That means that cancers like to hang on to everything. They don't like to get rid of anything.
No, I don't really know that much about astrology.
You don't?
I'm not sure. I'm a Scorpio. Does that mean anything?
They're very sexy.
Well, now, how can you say that?
Because they're supposed to be the sting and the tail. Scorpions are supposed to be the, that's what they say.
A Scorpio. A Scorpio with a padlock. I knew we'd get something out of this if we hung in here.
What is that?
That's now a Scorpio that we were working with this earlier.
Oh, I see. I said we're trying to get jokes
with this, and I think you just stumbled upon it. Yes, Fred, I know we have to take a break, and we'll do that. But we're coming back. We're back, and we're talking with Joan Collins. See. You ask what this was back here, and I don't blame you for asking. Guests sometimes look back and they see this rubber chicken. I can't remember how it started. I think we did a sketch one night and we had a rubber chicken in the sketch. And we put it back here, and for some reason, every single night of the show, that chicken is there.
It is there.
It's there. It's like
there, then it surprises you suddenly.
I don't know whether it's
coming
from good luck
your next guest
or superstitious or what. Now, they say most actors are superstitious. More in the theater, possibly, than anything else. But do you have superstition, things you will not do if you have a choice?
Oh, yes. Yes, absolutely. I mean, you will never quote a certain Shakespearean play in your dressing room. You'll never walk under a ladder. I touch wood all the time. And if I say the same word as somebody else, you always have to do a little thing with your finger.
Now, what's that called? Remember, you'd say sticks and... What goes up the chimney?
Oh, that must be American.
Smoke.
Smoke.
What comes down the chimney? Santa Claus. And then what do you say?
Hope our wishes won't be broke.
Hope our wishes won't be something like that.
I never heard that one.
What do they do in England?
Well, in England, they just say, you say the name of a poet, Shelley or Milton
Wadsworth,
or Browning or,
the, or anybody.
Wadsworth, yes, depending on how many poets you know.
When you think about it, isn't that silly?
Well,
I mean, superstitions generally.
I don't think so. I think that actors live so much by superstition. They live so much by luck, by being in the right place at the right time. I mean, that's how I got Dynasty, in a way, was by luck. And so you have to always think about your luck and worry about it, because you don't know what's going to happen.
Some writers, I think it was Hal Goodman and Larry Klein, gave me a pillar. Somebody that says it's all in the timing.
Oh, absolutely. Timing is everything. Who is it that said the talent is 10% and luck is 20% and the rest is
sweat.
Good.
No, I think.
Good looks.
I don't think that was Kierkegaard, was it? Henny Youngman said that at Grossinger's in 19... I don't know. What was the first time in your career that you were at the right place at the right time? When somebody said, hey, hello there, lovely girl?
When I was a kid, when I was at dramatic school.
Right.
I was 16, and I was doing some modeling.
Right.
And I was picked as one of the girls that they wanted to use for teenage modeling. And they were looking for a girl for a movie, a teenage juvenile delinquent girl. And so my picture was in this paper, this woman's magazine, and the agent saw it and called me up and said, do you want to be a movie actress?
A juvenile delinquent girl.
Yes, a baby bad girl.
You've always, not always, that's not a correct characterization, but you very often have played femme fatales, the loose woman, what's the word I want?
I don't know
the
why.
Wayward woman.
Yes.
Do you like that?
I played a nun once. You know, I...
Yeah, but she was fast. No, she wasn't.
She was a novice nun. I played all kinds of roles. I mean, I've done 50 movies and hundreds of TV shows. But I seem to have been remembered for the parts that I played that were a little bit meaty and a little bit juicy, because...
Don't you have more fun doing those?
Yes, I do. But I did do a very good Star Trek, which was called The City on the Edge of Forever, where I played a missionary worker. There's a Trekkie out there. Yeah. And I played an extremely nice woman. In fact, Bill Shatner fell in love with me.
Well, I'm not saying you can't play nice women.
I am a nice woman.
But if you, let's say, and who's somebody who is very... Marie Osmond, were up to play Mother Teresa.
Yes.
You might lose.
I mean, neither of us look exactly right for the part. I don't think.
What's the new television film you got coming up? Don't you have a new TV movie? Or?
Yes, I have one that's coming out in November called Male Model.
Now, what kind of a role do you play?
Well, I don't play the male model.
Well, I know that. No, makeup has not progressed that far yet. But...
I play a woman who runs a modeling agency. She finds this young, hunky guy who is crop spraying in Montana and says, you should be on the cover of Gentleman's Quarterly. And brings him to New York, and then they fall in love and they have a romance. And then he realizes that he'd rather be in Montana where it's clean and fresh and not in New York where it's, you know, bitter and twisted and nasty and everybody's having eye lifts at the age of 30.
We're just about out of time. As a matter of fact, we are almost out of time. Hey, it's nice to have you here tonight.
It's nice to be here.
Really, it's great to see you. Dynasty could probably run forever. How many countries has it seen it? Do you have any idea?
60. I didn't know there were that many countries.
Yeah.
No,
and they have to dub in all the dialogue,
they do,
don't they?
Yeah, but those residual checks come in.
Wouldn't you love to see that in Japanese?
I would. That's the only country it's not in.
Really?
The Japan has not bought it yet. I don't know why. But it's everywhere else.
It'll show up there. Thanks for being here.